Welcome to a Foxy Tech Tips tutorial on blocking websites on Google Chrome. If you find this tutorial helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking the video. For this tutorial, I will be blocking Facebook access on this browser. Start by going to blocksite.co. This is the website for the Chrome extension that we will be adding. Click where it says Add to Chrome. This will open the Chrome Web Store in a new tab. Click the Add to Chrome button here. On the pop-up, click Add Extension. In order for the extension to know what sites you are visiting in order to block them, you will need to click I accept here. You'll be taken to a landing page that is trying to get you to purchase premium or get a free trial, but you can just click the little skip button. This page is the dashboard for the application. You can enter the website you want to block in the text box, and then click the plus button. That website will now be blocked already. As you can see, when I load Facebook now, it blocks access. On the free version of this extension, you are allowed to add up to 6 sites to the blocklist. If you click the redirect button, you can enter a URL that you will be redirected to when you visit a blocked site. This is a good option if you often procrastinate when working. You can redirect yourself back to a productive site whenever you try to load a blocked site. You can set up a blocking schedule here so that sites are only blocked at certain times during the day. If you're setting this up for a child and not yourself, then it's a good idea to go over to the password protection section and set a password that will be required to unblock a site, and change any settings of this extension. You can also get an email alert if the extension gets uninstalled. You will need to create a free account with your email address for these features. You can unblock a site at any time by visiting the dashboard and clicking the red minus button next to the blocked site name. You can get back to this dashboard by clicking the extension icon in your toolbar, selecting the extension, and then tapping the settings icon for it. And that draws an end to this tutorial. Please like the video if you found it helpful and subscribe to Foxy Tech Tips for more tips and tricks.